Now we're ready to study the equilibrium dynamics. Notice that this clip is going to be one of the most important video clips in this aggregate expenditure lectures. Now recall the diagram of the 45 degree line and the aggregate expenditure schedule. At the intersection, we know this economy is in equilibrium because our output is exactly equal to the aggregate expenditure. Notice that this aggregate expenditure schedule, the green line, is cut by the 45 degree line. On the left-hand side of this aggregate expenditure schedule, notice that aggregate expenditure is greater than the output, meaning our economy is not producing enough stuff for our spending. So at this time, firms will try to produce more by hiring more workers. Now on the right-hand side of the 45 degree line on this aggregate expenditure schedule, you can see the output is greater than the aggregate expenditure, meaning firms have accumulated inventories they are not able to sell. So at this point, firms will try to cut the production by letting go some of their workers. Now supposedly initially we're in equilibrium, so our aggregate expenditure schedule is this green dotted line, and we have intersection between this aggregate expenditure schedule and our 45 degree line. Our output is 1-1, and that's exactly equal to our aggregate expenditure. Now, suppose there is an increase in the aggregate expenditure, say maybe the government spending has increased. Then our aggregate expenditure schedule is going to shift up. So now we are at a new point, we are out of equilibrium. In particular, our aggregate expenditure is higher than our output. So firms are running out of inventory for sale. And therefore, firms will try to hire more workers to produce more. After firms increase their production, output goes up from Y1 to Y2. And the firms are able to produce more because they also hire more workers. That means workers' income also goes up, and these workers are also consumers. After workers' income increase, they are also consumers, so they go ahead and increase their consumption. Therefore, consumption goes up, meaning aggregate expenditure is going to go up. So we're moving from the yellow point to the navy blue point. Now at this higher navy blue point, we are again out of equilibrium, meaning our aggregate expenditure is higher than our output, meaning firms are running out of inventories again. As firms are running out of inventory, they will increase their production from Y2 to Y3. So we're moving from this higher navy blue point to the purple point. This process will continue until we hit the new equilibrium, where our aggregate expenditure, AE star, is equal to our output, Y star, and that's a new equilibrium. Now suppose there is a decrease in the aggregate expenditure, let's say maybe as a result of a government spending cut, then that is going to cause our aggregate expenditure to shift down from this green dotted line to this red line. So now we are out of equilibrium. In particular, your output is higher than aggregate expenditure, meaning firms will have inventory accumulates, and the firms will try to cut their production by letting go some workers. Here, the firms cut their production, and as a result, output goes down from Y1 to Y2, and the firms are able to cut their production because they laid off some workers. And as a result, this worker's income goes down. Now, because these workers were laid off, with a smaller income, they will cut their consumption. As a result, aggregate expenditure is going to go down. So we're going down from this yellow point to this blue dot. This adjustment is going to continue until we hit the new equilibrium, the black dot, where aggregate expenditure, AE double star, is exactly equal to our new output, Y double star.